Hi, this is Patty Jackson. On this edition of Patty TV, we're gearing up for the 26th annual Philadelphia International Art Expo. Mercer Red Cross October Gallery is joining us. We're joining him here at the 7165 Lounge, formerly North by Northwest. 26 years, does it feel like it?
No, it doesn't. It's been quite a ride, quite a journey for the last 26 years. You know, being in the arts has so much reward to it. I mean, you're seeing the artwork, you're meeting artists, you're meeting creative people, and it just kind of gets your juices flowing. So it's been a good trip, it's been a good ride. The expo has been in 9 different locations over the 26 years. And so now we're in a new location, here at 7165 Germantown Avenue, the old North by Northwest. And if you look out the window here, you'll see Germantown Avenue, and it's going to be closed for the expo October 14th, 15th, and 16th. We're going to have close to 150 exhibitors. We have 10 visual artists coming from Brazil, 2 Ooh. From Nigeria, 1 from Bermuda, and across the country. We're really, really, really excited this year.
One of the things that I like about the October Gallery Art Expo, it's a great way to start your Christmas shopping. It is, because you can find, there's so many artists, and there's so many things to see and do, and it's going to be really interesting. I'm excited about this location, because we're talking about from the 70th block of Germantown Avenue to 7200 block of Germantown Avenue. The streets are going to be closed off, praying for great weather, but people can really come out and enjoy the arts and the great businesses that are on Germantown Avenue.
Absolutely, Patty, and I think that is one of the advantages that we see here this year. Even when we were at the Leopold Center, of course, we had 50,000 square feet. We covered every inch of it. But one of the challenges we had, when people wanted to get something to eat, they had to get on the bus, go downtown. Here, there are 8 restaurants.
Yes.
Mexican, traditional, soul food, whatever you want. So now people can come and make a day of it, make a weekend of it, and they don't have to leave the avenue to eat, to enjoy the art. We have a fitness facility here. So it's just all-encompassing, and it's the art of being well.
That's the arts,
with the food, with everything that's here, so it's really exciting.
There's a health component to this. Tell us about the health and wellness part of this.
Yes. We have the wellness pavilion this year. They're going to be doing all sorts of things, massages, how to eat right, blood pressure testing, diabetes testing, all these challenges that we have in our community that concern us, it's going to be there. There's going to be a raw food component, because raw food is becoming more and more popular. And it's not just the selling of the food. It's explaining why raw food might be good for an individual. People have to decide whether or not it works for them. They will be doing massages. They'll have a diabetes symposium. They'll have a symposium on breast cancer. They're just covering the gamut. And it works. People say, well, what does that have to do with the art?
Yeah.
The idea is it's the art of living well, the art
yes.
of taking care of your body, the art of taking care of your temple. And all that's done in an environment of African-American artists that come from all over the country, and they're the people who drive this event. And it's just exciting to know that our culture and our art and what's important to us as African-Americans drives this event. And it's not just for African-Americans, that's what you find. But it's for everyone. Of course, you know this is a very diverse neighborhood
yes,
here.
Yes,
and so we're really excited this year. I say this, my accountant says I shouldn't say it, my lawyer, whatever. When we started, there were probably about 99% African American. Over the years, it slid down. Probably the last year with the Leopold Center, it was probably about 85-80% African American, and the rest was non-African American. And this year, of course, that's going to slide down even further. And I'm only saying for the reason that African-American art and our culture is becoming not just important to us, but to other cultures. And they're coming to see it, and we are excited.
October 14th, 15th, and 16th on the Ave, Germantown Avenue, 7165 The Lounge. That's where you can find us. We're going to be here to help support. October Gallery has been doing this for 26 years. We're going to give you a peek, a look at some of the fabulous artwork. make sure you make plans to join us. What's the website?
Website is MountAiryArtExpo.com. That's Mount Airy Art. You can also give us a call. We man the phones. We're here on the phones at 215. I'm old school. I'm sorry. I do email. I do Facebook.
But check this number out. Check out this number.
215-629-3939. 215-629-3939. If I can mention, Patty, Breakwater's going to be here. They're going to perform Friday night. Saturday night, we have George Fox and the G Fox Experience, which is Teddy Pendergrass. I mean, this guy sounds and looks just like Teddy Pendergrass. And of course, on Sunday, we're going to play Sunday Out in UGO, Urban Guerrilla Orchestra.
Wow.
So there's lots to do here, lots of food.
What time does it start during the day?
Okay, during the day, we start at 10 a.m. and go to 7 p.m. Friday and Saturday. Sundays from 10 a.m. till 6 p.m. The Art Expo is absolutely free. There are some fees for the concert. Go online, MountAiryArtExpo.com, and check that out.
Mercer Red Cross October Gallery, we will see you at the 26th Annual Philadelphia International Art Expo.